Sometimes you're at the airport and it's just too thunderstormy, so you have to stay on the ground. And I totally get that. But sometimes it's just hot or cold or cloudy. What's going on, planes? Why can't you fly? Flight seems simple, though it is anything but. Planes are expected to traverse so many different climates and conditions, and yet they aren't magic. They're based on science and engineering, so we have to try and break them. Manufacturers flood the engines of their planes to see how much water they can ingest flying through a storm before failing. They fire dead birds into the engines to see how many it takes to break the internal workings. Test flights are done in varying levels of ice, snow, and rainfall. Engineers even figure out how long the runway needs to be at different altitudes for planes to stop safely. But sometimes nature gets in the way of best laid plans. For example, during a heat wave, planes can't get off the ground. Remember when temperatures soared to almost 120 degrees in Phoenix back in June 2017? Planes were grounded all over the place. When a plane is grounded for heat like that, it has less to do with hot planes and more to do with hot air. Airplanes fly when the air moving over the wing is less dense than the air moving under the wing, creating lift. Hot air is less dense than cold air, meaning there are fewer molecules for the airplane's wing to fly on top of. To get lift, the plane will need more speed to get the air moving fast enough to generate pressure on the underside of the wing. In Arizona that time, the airport just didn't have enough runway to get planes going fast enough when it was that hot. So there's just no way to leave the ground. Cold can also cause problems. Yes, it's cold at 30,000 feet and above, so you'd think planes would be okay with cold, but not entirely. The main issue is still about air moving around the wing. If, say, ice builds up on a wing, it can change how air moves, which screws up lift, just like with hot air. But also, jet fuel can in fact freeze if it gets too cold. There are jet fuel types, just like gas for your car, and regular Jet A fuel freezes below negative 40 Celsius, and the Jet A1 fuel below negative 47 Celsius. Though it probably won't get that cold in a Michigan winter, in Russia or Antarctica, it could be a problem. Airplane manufacturers test their planes to make sure pilots and engineers know what the craft can and cannot do. Just like some planes can fly higher or faster, some don't take off well in high winds or don't fly very well with a strong tailwind. Planes are even tested for turbulence tolerance, which ultimately comes down to how far the wings can flex. To test that, they put the wings through this terrifyingly incredible test. This is a stress test on a wing of a Boeing 777. They built a machine to simulate the plane carrying more and more weight, and it finally snaps at 154 times what it was designed to lift. FYI, there's no way a wing would actually bend like that or fall off in regular flight. We have a whole video about it. The goal of all these tests are to get the plane to fail under more stress than the plane would likely experience. That way they know it won't break under normal flight and landing, and if something does go wrong in these extreme conditions, we understand how and why it happened. All this gives airlines the limits at which the plane can fly to keep everyone safe. And it works. Commercial flying is still the safest way to travel. For more epic stories of innovation that shaped our future, check out theageofaerospace.com. Have you ever wondered why some planes look bigger on the inside? We talked to some engineers about the tricks they use to do just that. You can check it out here. I love flying in big planes. They got big windows and the design is so cool. You're basically in a giant tube in the sky, but you don't feel like it. What do you think? Tell us in the comments. Please subscribe for more Seeker. Thanks for watching.